It's shame that something as beautiful as this caterpillar is really a pest. Because it's quite incredible, you know, how perfectly it's formed.
Yes, this is the larva of the monarch butterfly.
And, oh, really? I don't want to kill that.
No, but these have a very voracious appetite, and they will really eat everything. And let's see, if we can stroke him a little, we can get his antennas possibly to come up here, if we're lucky.
I hear some oohs and ahs out there.
Yeah, my daughter does this, and she does it perfectly, and I'm not going to be so lucky, but...
Let's see if I have the touch.
Yeah. If we can get him, he's coming after me.
Yeah. He likes you.
He likes me, yes.
Are you exuding?
What you might want to do with something like this is just simply pick them off and get rid of them. But he's on a parsley plant that we found, and he would devour the whole parsley plant.
Just if we left him alone?
Yes.
Okay, we'll put him back over here to make sure that that was not the only thing on. Now, let's see what else we've got here. Some tomatoes?
Yeah, let's switch to some vegetable crops here. This is a common ailment of tomatoes that are planted early, and this is called blossom end rot. And this is a physiological condition, which means it's not an insect or a disease. The plants have been stressed, and this is possibly from planting them too early, from a lack of calcium in the soil, or a lack of moisture. And this really plagues tomato growers. This is called blossom end rot.
Okay, that's the problem, doctor. What do you do to fix it?
Okay, well,
obviously this tomato is pretty well gone.
Right.
this patient can't be saved.
Right. First thing is plant your tomatoes later. Most people are always rushing the season, and the old farmers in the Cleveland area plant them about May 25th. Tomato is tropical.
Didn't know I could do that.
No, I didn't. Can you do it with three of them?
Later. All right, now we've got a couple of rhododendron plants here. They're pretty sorry. In fact, I'd almost be willing to give these to somebody in the audience. You know, as a door prize. Who wants this thing?
This is kind of a mystery ailment, and you'll go out to your rhododendrons and you'll find that something has been chewing on them, but you never get to see what it is. And this is a black vine weevil that attacks the rhododendron, and it comes out of the soil and chews in the evening and then goes back down.
Is it down in that plant now?
It should be down there now, yes. This was taken out of a yard.
Get out of there! And what do you do to fix it?
This, you would want to apply an insecticide that you can drench the soil with, and this particular one is called lindane.
Lindane?
Lindane.
What else does it work for, Alan?
Borers, for peach tree borers, for... On birch trees, there's a myriad.
And this goes
things.
In a soil around
yes,
the plant?
Yes, you'll want to mix this in a watering can and water it in, and this will take care of them.
What are we talking about in terms of a delay, then, before you actually see the end of the problem?
Okay, this one will be immediate. This is a very, this is an example of an insecticide that is a little more dangerous, and that you should read the directions and take the necessary precautions.
Now, what about using something like this around plants or too close to the lawn? Is that going to hurt
the grass?
There
is no problem there. It is not for use around edible crops.
Now, this other rhododendron that you have is just plain puny, really.
People love rhododendrons, but they seem to have lots of trouble with them. And this one is called dieback, and this is just a disease, and it just suddenly attacks the rhododendron, and the whole plant dies.
So we're not talking about a lack of fertilizer?
It can be caused from a lack of fertilizer, a lack of moisture, a poor soil. The rhododendron needs an excellent growing conditions to do well in this area. They do not like our heavy clay.
Now, in the front of my house, I have some big rhododendrons that have gradually turned very sick, I think. Should I bring them back with what kind of a fertilizer?
Just any type of evergreen fertilizer that states that it's for rhododendrons. That's an acid-type fertilizer.
Acid-type?
There is nothing that you can do to treat this directly. The ball game's pretty much over for this plant.
Okay, just look under your chair, and if you got the lucky number, you can take
the rhododendron.
Now, this is somebody has been eating on our cabbage, and I don't think it was a rabbit.
Yes, this is the type of damage that you get from such as the larva that we were looking earlier.
No, I see. That caterpillar might have done that.
Yes, this is the type of damage that they'll do. And if you go out into your garden, you're going to have to apply something or get rid of whatever is chewing on it.
Let me ask you a really stupid question. I'm sure all these women know the answer to this question. But there's nothing wrong. You could eat that just the same, right? You could cook it up and eat it.
Oh, sure. If you ate the insect, it might be a little more nutritious for you.
High in protein.
Now, we got a bunch of dead-looking things here. I'm not even sure these don't go together, do they?
No, they're all similar diseases, though. And this is one that is called anthracnose. That's a very long name, but it's very common. It's just a leaf disease, and it attacks maples, and this is on a horse chestnut, and we also have it on your right hand on a Japanese maple.
This is the disease then out here where it's
yes,
turned
yes,
really yellow.
Yes, it's called anthracnose.
Mm-hmm. And is there a chemical that you use?
Yes, there is. And this is a very old-fashioned one called Bordeaux mix. It's a copper spray that was developed in France for the grape vineyards.
Mm-hmm. In fact, it's 12.75% copper. That's a lot of copper.
Yes, and it's very safe to use, and it's very effective.
Anybody have that on any of their plants? Those little brown spots on their leaves? Okay, that's
Bordeaux
the thing
mix
right there.
Is what you want.
All right, now let's see what happened to this thing. Is this another caterpillar?
Yes, this is the, and I think we still have the Japanese beetle.
Japanese beetle is still in there.
Come over here.
What did that plant used to be?
Which one was the, these used to be salvias.
Where is he?
things are hopping off after.
I don't know.
Yes, these are salvia. They get a large red flower. This is typical of what will happen in your yard unless you do something. They will eat off all the flowers, all the leaves, everything.
You can see them climbing around now.
They just love the heat in here, and they really go at it.
Alrighty, what about that little ivy thing there? What is that?
This is a euonymus.
A what?
A euonymus.
Oh, yeah.
Euonymus.
Marlon Perkins used to have these on Wild Kingdom all the time. Okay, now Jim Fowler will go shoot a euonymus. No, the plant is a euonymus, but what are all these white
spots? This is a scale. And if we can come in close on that.
Okay, I think they can just barely see it. Kind of point it with your finger there.
Okay, let's get rid of this and right in here.
All right, wait a minute. Let's see. Right?
How are we doing? There we go.
Yeah, now we can see it.
That is a scale, and that is an actual insect. And this is the adult stage of the insect. And in this stage, he finds a suitable place on the leaves, and he just sucks juices out of the leaves, and he loses his legs, and he just spends his time right there.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Now our spray for this one, I'm going to have to point this out.
Wait a minute, you got a bug in your beard there. Wait just a minute. Hold still. I don't know what, a little cricket.
My wife is always finding
what is that?
Strange things. I think maybe a little cricket, I'm not sure.
See, right there.
Yeah, he likes you better than me now.
When was the last time you took a bath, Alan? All right, so what do we get to do for the scaly bugs here?
What we want to use, and I'll trade with you here today.
Your basic malathion?
Malathion. This is what they are spraying California with, and it's caused all the excitement.
All right, what do you think about that? They're talking about fogging this from planes or something?
Right, they're fogging it. When I was in the Army in Texas, this was very common. They sprayed all of parts of Texas with malathion, and no one said a thing about it.
Well, sure, down south when I was growing up, even today. I mean, tonight, there'll be misting for mosquitoes all over the Gulf Coast.
This is nothing new as long as it's used correctly and that people watch it. If the people in California want their fruit crops, they best do something about it.
But now, you mix this with the water, or is it ready to go like it is?
No, it has to be mixed with water. And again, you should read the directions and use it correctly.
Do you, when you have those scale insects like that, should you also take something and wipe them off?
There are organic cures for a lot of these things. The problem with organic cures on large scales is that it's just too expensive. As they found in California,
organic meaning
pick the fruit or something, it's just way too expensive. And so you have to go to sprays.
We got some questions about Japanese beetles or any other thing that we've talked about so far, scale insects? I can't believe that all of you know every single thing that there is to know about this stuff. Okay, we got somebody right over here. Would you stand, please?
Well, earlier you mentioned something about the EPA as a control over the insecticides.
Yes.
Is that an organization of the government?
Yeah.
Yes, it is.
Environmental Protection Agency.
Oh. Okay.
They supposedly, but then there are a lot of people who are very suspicious of the government. And they say, don't believe it if the government says it. All right, who's got a Japanese beetle problem that really doesn't think that her question or her problem has been solved so far? If you do all those things, you think you're going to get rid of them?
No.
You don't think so? Yes.
If you spray...
Can you stand, please? That's part of the process.
Spray red raspberries, how soon can you use them afterwards?
Good question.
It depends on what you spray them with. Some of the things like 7 can almost be used the day of harvest. On the back of the package, it will tell you how soon you can eat them, how soon you can harvest them after they're sprayed.
Yes.
This is not about Japanese beetles,
no,
but
that's right.
That copper powder or spray that you had?
The Bordeaux.
Now, that is used for a large tree. That is, it was used for trees. Now, what part of the tree would you sprinkle that on? Just the part that is directly...
Where the leaves
that has
are being
the blight?
No, this is a powder that is dissolved in water, and you spray the entire tree.
Oh, I'm thinking of just spraying the leaves.
This is a what is called a wettable powder, which means it dissolves in water and you spray the whole tree.
Okay, we're going to take a quick break. We got another whole table full. In fact, we got a bunch of more things we're going to roll in and look at and answer some more questions, and I'm sure they're the same kinds of things you're wondering. So Alan Hirt and I will return in just a minute after this.